Are you laboring, feeling heavy laden? Is your soul thirsting for more? Are you laboring, feeling heavy laden? Is your soul thirsting for more? Will I Yes, I know a place where you can go. Yes, I know a place to find a rest, rest for your soul. Into his presence, come into his presence, into his presence. Lay your burdens on the Lord. Into his presence, come into his presence, into his presence, and find shelter from the storm. Into his presence, come into his presence, into his presence, and find rest. Rest for your soul. In Jesus' presence, in Jesus' presence, in Jesus' presence, there is joy, life, peace forevermore. In Jesus' presence, in Jesus' presence, there is joy and life and peace forevermore. There is joy, life and peace forevermore.
Still lost.
listen to the story. Together giving glory to Jesus, the blessed Lamb of God. Anointed One, Your life has conquered death forevermore. Jesus.
All right, let's get started here tonight, folks. April 3rd, Wednesday night. Amen. Let's stand, or let's clap our hands, and we'll sing out that song. Make a joyful. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. For He is worthy to be praised. Sing with your spirit and clap with your hands. Our God is greatly to be praised. Worthy, worthy, He is worthy to be praised. Alleluia, our God is greatly to be praised. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, for He is worthy to be praised. Sing with your spirit, clap with your hands. Our God is greatly to be praised. Worthy, worthy, He is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah, our God is greatly to be praised. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, for He is worthy to be praised. Sing with your spirit, clap with your hands. Our God is greatly to be praised. Worthy, worthy, He is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah, our God is greatly to be praised. He is worthy, worthy, He is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah, our God is greatly to be praised.
All right, let's stand, let's sing out that good old song, God is greater, or God is great, greatly to be praised. Wonderful song, let's sing it out tonight, church.
God is great and greatly to be praised. Glory, glory to His name. God is great and greatly to be praised. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. I will bow before His majesty. The Lord, oh my soul.
Sing it again.
God is great and greatly to be praised. Glory, glory to Him.
made to be praised. Bless the Lord, O my soul. I will bow before His majesty. I will lift my voice and sing. God is great and greatly to be praised. Bless the Lord, O my. One more time from the top. God is great and greatly to be praised. Glory, glory to His name. God is great and greatly to be praised. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. God is great and greatly to be praised. Glory. Bless the Lord, O my soul. I will bow before His majesty. I will lift my voice and sing. God is great and greatly to be praised. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Oh, bless the Lord, O one more time. And bless the Lord, oh my soul. Praise God. Almost lost count there, amen. We're going to slow it down tonight, church. Salvation belongs to our wonderful God. Let's sing it out to Him, leaving all our problems, amen, behind. Let's begin to focus on God tonight, lifting our hearts tonight. Sing it out.
Salvation belongs to our God, who sits upon the throne, and unto the Lamb praise and glory, wisdom and strength, honor and power.
Give Him praise. Hallelujah. Blessed be the Lamb. Lamb of God, we praise You. Worthy, worthy Jesus. Amen. Wonderful God, amen. We want to go before him and pray. How many need prayer tonight? We need God to move, amen. Let's pray for you. Let's believe God for you, amen. Let's believe God for our church members. Believe God for those who are sick and need healing. Let's pray for those who are in need, amen. You have needs. Let's pray for your need. Believing God to touch you, amen. Let's believe God to move upon you tonight. God to move, amen, in the service. God to supernaturally provide for our needs, amen, that we have those signified by hands, amen, tonight. Let's pray for our leaders. Continue to pray for wisdom. Pastor Payne and his wife Janice, Pastor Mitchell, his wife Lisa, Pastor Artie and Sandra there in Chinle, our mother church. Continue to pray. God have his hand upon them. Let's lift up Pastor Artie and Pastor Adam Braxton. They are again on their way. They probably already are there, right? They're probably already in Adam's in Vietnam right now, scouting the land. And so we want to pray for his safe traveling mercies. God has his hand upon them as they get set up to go with him and his family. So let's believe God for them as, again, the rubber is meeting the road and it's coming to fruition where they have to go and go overseas and minister the gospel. Amen. So let's pray for them, the mother church there, and all our brethren across, amen, the board here, believing God to touch these workers. Amen. Every one of them, the Braxtons as well, amen. Let's pray for our workers in Canada, our leader, Pastor Marks, on this side of the provinces, Pastor LaValle on the other side of the provinces. Let's believe God for these workers, God to move upon them and their churches, amen, tonight. So let's believe God for them, amen. Many of them here listed, amen. We want to pray for them. Many, many years they have been laying down their lives, preaching the gospel, a hope, amen, a hospital for sinners, amen, for you and I to go to. We can be healed by the word of God. They're out there, you know, spiritual hospitals. And so let's pray, God, give them an increase. God, give them favor tonight. Let's believe God together. Amen. Praying. God, meet with us tonight. And let's also lift up Audrey. Her birthday's today. Amen. Let's believe God to bless her and be with her. Amen. And be with you as well. Amen. God bless you. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this day. Father, we thank you for this night. We've gathered, God. We call upon you. We worship you. We thank you for all that you have done, Lord God. All that you are doing. Keep us. Preserve us, God. Continue, Lord God, as we draw closer to you, God. Reveal yourself to us. God, move upon, God, Israel. Continue to protect, God. God, those in Taiwan, God, have your hand upon them, God. Lord, we need you, Jesus. Lord, let hearts be drawn to you in these days we live in, my God. Lord, we need you tonight. Let your word impact us. Stir the gift of God within us, we pray. Lord, we love you. We thank you tonight. Amen. Let's give him praise, church. Hallelujah. Lord, oh wonderful Jesus, worthy, worthy, oh God, you are. Amen, amen. Why don't you welcome each other and we'll get started here again, church.
Jesus, anointed one, your life has conquered death forevermore. Jesus declared the Son with power, raised up Lord of all, you are Lord of all. Exalted are you, Lord, exalted are you, Lord. You're high and lifted up over every other name. Exalted are you, Lord, exalted are you, Lord.
All right, let's go ahead and begin here tonight, church. We do welcome you. Thank God for you for coming in this place and enjoying service. We enjoy having you here. We do have a couple of announcements. As you know, our services, don't forget our service times here on the bulletin. 10:30 is our next service Sunday. Be inviting folks. It'd be a great, great thing if you, again, are working with someone or, you know, somebody needs Jesus, needs to be encouraged, invite them out to church. It'd be a wonderful thing to bring them in, amen, to church. And, again, it'd be a great, great thing. So invite them out, bring them in. It's 6:30 in the evening time as well.
And just so, again, we just have another important announcement as we begin service. I didn't want you to find out coming some Sunday morning and you're wondering what's going on outside, or Wednesday, and there's a sign outside that says for sale. With just a heads up, the manager or the landlord here in this building, they're going to be selling this place. So be praying with me. Believe God with me for another establishment, another church building. So again, he's going to be, I just got wind of this week. So I don't want you guys to be looking outside. We're for sale. It's what's going on, you know. The sign's going to go up in a few days. And so I just wanted to give you a heads up. And it's been a wonderful home here in this place. And you know what? I believe God has a better place. Amen. And you know, maybe God's just nudging us. You know, you never know. Like, there's more. There's more places, you know, more bigger place possibly. Because we pack this place out, man, when we have a good showing of revival or potluck. How many know there's a lot of people and we get crammed in here? So maybe it's a good sign. You know what? God is just pushing us to grow more, expand the tent, as they say in the Bible. And believe God with me, though. Pray and fast with me when you can. And just believe God for a place to open up. Give us favor, just like it was here. So, again, just believe God with me. So, just so you won't have a surprise outside. What's going on, Pastor? What's happening? And so, just to give you a heads up. But just pray with us. Believe God with us. Amen. For that to be so. For something to open up here in Saskatoon. Amen. So, there's so much in Saskatoon. And so, believe God. Give us a favor in this city. Amen. Wonderful favor with a landlord. Amen. So, but those are the announcements. We're going to go ahead and give. Let's go ahead and give. Again, I appreciate every faithful giver, everyone who's been faithful in giving and supporting. We have many ways to give. I encourage you, let's continue to be faithful in honoring God. Amen. And how many know God doesn't forget all that we have given? God does not forget all that we have given. I mean, you know, he doesn't forget, you know, when he says, if you give my servant a water, you know, a drink, you're going to be rewarded. How many know he says that in the Bible? He says, you're going to be blessed. You're going to be rewarded. If you even bless, you know what, the least of these. Let me tell you, God doesn't forget or overlook our gifts. Amen. Our sacrifices, our offerings, our tithes. And let me tell you, God blesses and God touches, amen, our finances for that. I pray always. You know what? I was telling our landlord today, we were talking more. I said, you know what? I know God's going to help you. I know. I just said, whatever you do, I just pray that you get more than you're asking for this place, because he's been a blessing to us, amen. And as you bless God and God's people, you know, there's a blessing in store for people who do that, amen. And so remember that, amen. That's a godly principle. And we honor God. We do it in lieu of, you know, I'm just honoring God. I want to honor God. You know, not like, how much am I going to get back? What is going to happen? No, it's it's honoring God, and God will honor and bless you. Amen. So let's give tonight. Let's be faithful. If you have not, amen, had a chance, here's your chance. Let's give. Let's bow our heads. Let's pray for our finances, our needs tonight, for whatever it may be, homes, cars, you know, better wisdom in dealing with this. You know, let's believe God. Amen. Let's believe God for you tonight. Father, we come before you, Lord God, this evening. But Lord, I am praying, loosen, Lord God, I pray. Pray liberality. God, open the windows of heaven, Lord God, for those who are in need, Lord God. We call upon you tonight, God. Breathe upon our needs, Lord Jesus. You see them. You know them, my God. Begin to move upon them in your timing. In Jesus' name we pray and we thank you in advance, Lord, for what you're going to do, Lord God. Buildings, Lord God. Homes, Lord God. God, we thank you in advance for pouring out, Lord Jesus, for you have many, Lord, blessings, Lord God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Let's sing out that song one time through, and we'll give tonight, church. And he set me free, yes, he set me free. He broke the bonds of prison for me. I'm glory bound, my feet. God, he set me free. All right. Thank you for giving faithfully. Everyone has been giving faithfully. And I just did our monthly report for our mother church there in Chilliwack just yesterday. And appreciate, you know, you guys gave and gave last month. And it was such a blessing, amen. We're able to function, amen, and pull our weight as well as a church. Thank God for you. And again, believe God though with me. Really do believe God with me for a new place, for a location. And believe God to help us. And God to move, amen. So those, with that, we're going to go ahead and take our Bibles out. Oh, there's no Sunday, there's no children's church tonight. Ashley, Ashley's back there. She's gonna come up with another lesson real soon. And so tonight, this out of the book of Mark, I want to rehash some of the what I've ministered on. I touched on it last week, last service, about issues that we go through. How many of you know we go through issues in life? We deal with issues, and the definition of issues I want to begin with clearly are problems. Problems that we have. Issues. People have issues that they are dealing with. I was asking some of the pastors out of the Chimney Church, Pastor Morgan, Pastor Pete, you know, and Pastor Deadman and Pastor Dempsey in the last couple of days. I said, what issues do you deal with? You know, what issues? I want to start a series, and I want some of your input of issues that people deal with and come to you wanting to be dealt with, you know, and they began to give me some great insight and a lot of material to work with. We're starting this series tonight on issues because we're going to go in depth on some things, you know, of issues that we deal with, you know, barrenness issues where we're not fruitful, you know what, physically or in finances, you know what, in our lives, we're not spiritually bearing things or physically bearing things. And we have issues. I mean, we have a lot of things we deal with. People sometimes come into church and they say, Pastor, I have issues. You know, I've heard that over and over. Many other pastors say that. I got issues, Pastor. You know, what's wrong? I have issues, you know. And it's like, yes, we all have issues. And that's tonight's message. We all have issues. We're going to look at the woman with the issue of blood. Mark 5, 25 through 34. And as I said, we all deal with issues in life, things that we are dealing with, struggling with, things that seem to not go away. Have you ever felt like that? It's like it just keeps on coming back. It's like it's just a nagging issue in life. It would be like Paul, remember the apostle, he said, it's like, you know what, there's this thorn on my side, and it's always there, no matter what. How many know that's a picture of this woman's infirmity of flowing blood? And so we're going to get into that, but let's read as we begin, Mark 5, 25 through 34, the account of this woman. There is so much to grasp take away from this story. Let's read. It says, now a certain woman had a flow of blood for 12 years and had suffered many things from many physicians. She had spent all that she had and was no better, but rather grew worse. When she heard about Jesus, she came behind him in the crowd. And she touched his garment, and she said, if only I may touch his clothes, I shall be made well. Immediately, the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of the affliction. And Jesus, immediately knowing in himself that power had gone out from him, turned around in the crowd and said, who touched my clothes? But his disciples said to him, you see the multitude thronging you, Lord, and you say, who touched me? And he looked around to see her who had done this thing. Verse 33, but the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what had happened to her, came and fell down before Jesus and told him the whole truth. And he said to her, daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your affliction. Amen. Let's pray tonight. Father, we come, Lord God, asking you,
God, to begin to, Lord, mend some wounds. God, begin to heal some infirmities. God, begin to help us. God, know the way, Lord God, how to heal and deal with these issues we have in our lives. Lord, we call upon you by faith. God, begin to do a work in us. Lord, we are speaking life. God, we are speaking healing in the name of Jesus. Touch us, I pray. Lord, we thank you tonight. And everyone said, amen, amen. I want to look firstly at the flowing issues of life. That word issue, if you define it in the Strong's concordance, it's defined as a flux of blood, an issue, or a flowing issue. And I began to think, you know what? A flowing issue is more than just that infirmity of this blood continually lasting 12 years or more. I mean, you know, there are flowing issues in life that continue to flow in our life, things that we deal with constantly. It seems like one thing passes and, you know, we take care of it. You know, it's like, oh man, I'm glad that's done with. I'm glad that is over with, you know, that trial or that issue, you know. And then something comes in the chamber the next round and it's like, oh my gosh, here we go again, you know. And you buckle down and you begin to deal with that issue. You know, living in Canada in this house, with a basement, there's all kinds of issues that I've had to deal with, even to this very hour, of water seeping into the foundation, through the walls, and into the basement. I've never had to deal with some of these issues. You know, the first winter we had our battery freeze up, 2017 December, and it froze, and we were stuck at home. Nothing was working, and I was like, what is going on? And I look at my battery, I pop my hood, and it's an ice cube. My battery is an ice cube. My car, my van at that time was an Arizona car, and so I had no insulation or nothing, no block heater, you know, nothing. And so we were frozen there, and our car couldn't go nowhere for almost a week until I brought my battery in and let it defrost slowly. Issues we dealt with, you know, my bicycle being stolen, Casey's bike being stolen and put on the fence in our back neighbor's yard, and so many issues, you know, having to deal with. It's like one thing after another, we take care of something, and then it's another thing. How many ever felt like that in life? It's like it's always ongoing. Lord, give me strength. God, help me. That's the only thing we need. You know, that's going to help us is Jesus Christ. Because we have things that happen that break down. Our health, our finances, our vehicles, you know, homes, you know, things like that. It's issues of life. We have to continue. God provide buildings. God provide a place for us. God move. This woman dealt with her issues for 12 years. How many ever had a festering issue for 12 years? An addiction for 12 years or more. It's been like this all my life, Pastor. I've been this way, and this is how it's always going to be. No, it cannot, shall not be, it should not be. You got to get it in your head that, you know what, that I can live a life of freedom and deliverance. You know, I don't have to have and settle for this life, you know, where I'm downtrodden always, and the devil's always going to have rule and reign in my life. How many know it does not have to be that way? Jesus said, those who are free indeed. If you call on his name, you begin to apply his truth, his word in your life, and you begin to walk, his word in this world, begin to walk his truth, his commandments. As you begin to build your life on that and with it, you know what? You will begin to live in freedom if you will begin to walk in the Spirit. These issues come and go. This woman, for years, she dealt with this. It's asked today, somebody asked me, how long you been living in Canada? I said, September will be 7 years.
7 years already, and it's one issue after another. You know what? In this wonderful country, and it's like, man, there's nothing else like living in Canada, man. Minus 40, you know, there's an issue right there for you. It's like, man, cold. It's cold. You know, pipes are freezing. The water's off. Dad, what happened to the water? I'm like, oh, let me get my hair dryer. Defrost these pipes, you know, one issue after another. But we keep going and we keep encouraged. And you know what? Things could be worse, amen. Things could be worse, but thanks be to God, we got the Lord. This woman gave all her expenses to healing, to finding the cure of her issue, the elixir, finding something to cure her. Have you ever heard of experimental treatments? You know what? This woman gave to all kinds of physicians. Can you stop this? Is there something you can give me? Is there something you can do? Is there something? I'm tired of this. I'll give you whatever you want. And they did all kinds of tests on her. They gave her all kinds of medication, medical experiments, and nothing helped. And she had no money. She spent everything. She exhausted every resource she had. And all the while, I mean, oh, Jesus was the answer. If I could just touch him, if I could just have an encounter with him, I will be healed. And she goes to Jesus. And that is the answer to all our issues. And we're going to go into more. We're going to dive into some issues that we go through, things that are more too close to home for you and I. Because right now we're just being broad on the issues topic here. And this woman here with the issue of blood, we go through that with the flowing issues in our life. Whatever it may be, you need to begin to pray, God, there's this issue I'm dealing with. There's this addiction. There's this sorrow. I can't get over this. God, there's this on my mind. I can't break it up. God, it just keeps bothering me. Once I wake up, it's there. Once I go to sleep, right before I go to sleep, it's there, nagging. God, help me. You need to begin to pray for those nagging issues in your life. There are many, just like that devil. Our name is Legion, for our many. And there's like many issues we deal with. Secondly, where do these issues come from? Some of them are self-inflicted. There was a sermon I preached a couple of years ago, a sermon called It's Not Your Fault. And the antithesis of this sermon was, it might be your fault. You might be shooting yourself in the foot. Why am I cursed? What's wrong? Is it the devil? Sometimes it's the devil. How many of the issues in life that we deal with is the devil? And sometimes it's self-inflicted. Have you ever seen someone shoot themselves with a gun? I mean, not suicidal or anything like that. I'm not getting that. I'm not going there. God help you, you know, those who are going to. But they accidentally shoot their toe or their leg. Have you ever seen that? You know, you're going to Google it, you know, YouTube it. You know, man accidentally shoots himself, you know. And this guy is a quick draw. And he goes, he tries to be quick, you know. And he pulls his pistol out of his holster. And for some reason, he shoots right here before he even can aim it and take it out. You know, he goes, wha-bam! Oh, I just shot myself, and he's bleeding from his leg or his thigh. And I was thinking, man, I mean, you know, some of the issues we deal with, sometimes self-inflicted. We shoot ourselves in the foot. The issues we're dealing with, it's the devil, Bazar, it's the devil. I remember the scripture, it talks about, you know, the blind man and the disciples ask him, whose fault is it? John 9, 1 through 7, as Jesus passed by, he saw a man who was blind from birth, and his disciples asked him, saying, Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? And Jesus said, neither this man nor his parents sinned, but the works of God should be revealed in him. I must work the works of him who sent me while it is day. The night is coming when no one can work. And as long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world. and he heals him. He heals him completely. He says, go to the pool of Siloam, and translate it, sent. He went washed, and he came back seeing. Sometimes they are from the devil, and I don't know that old question, Pastor, why is this happening? Why did that have to happen? You know what? I wish I could tell you. This is where, you know what? You need to pray, God, help me. God, process this. God, what is going on? Why is this happening? These issues I'm dealing with of barrenness, God, of unable, Lord God, to be encouraged or have the victory. What is happening? And sometimes it's just ourselves and our decisions that we made, which is contrary to what is right. Why am I cursed? It's the devil. It's the devil. No. Sometimes it's just us making foolish decisions. We're not doing what's right. I mean, the Bible says that, you know what? Those who hear and knows the truth and does not do it, it is as sin. You know the truth. You know what you need to do. And if you don't do it, it's like sin. You know what? You know the truth, and you're not doing it. Don't blame God. Don't blame the devil. It's blaming. You know, you need to look in the mirror and see who to blame, because you're making the wrong choices, especially knowing the truth. It's like you're trying to build furniture, Walmart furniture, IKEA furniture, and you're trying to put it together. I can't put it together. It's IKEA's fault. But they have the whole instruction manual right there before you. It's IKEA's fault for what? Giving you instructions on how to put it together, right? Yeah, darn IKEA, you know. No, it's you. I mean, God's given us the Bible. It's the devil's fault. It's God's fault. And I always tell the girls, make sure before you realize, you know what, while you're pointing, there's three fingers pointing right back at you. It's so-and-so's fault. It's their fault. You know, it's probably our fault. Maybe we're not obeying God. Maybe we're not listening to God. See, this is where the issues come from. And we blame all these things, and it's us. Where do these issues come from? Like I said, some of them are from the devil. Some of them are from hell. Some of these things do come from hell, where they're trying to discourage you. How many of you know that is a dart from hell, a fiery dart to entice you to sin, to entice you to do wrong? Thou shalt not surely die. Why don't you take a bite, Eve? How many of you know that's what the devil does, entice you to do wrong, disobey God. And then we have the issue of sin there. And we got to deal with that issue. Whatever your issue is tonight, we're gonna look into them, because there are things we need to examine and pray about and fix when we are going to deal with those issues. We're not blessed. God's not moving in our life. I believe God should be moving in your life. How many of you believe that? God should be moving in your heart. God should be changing you. You should always be morphing, transforming, amen, to be more perfect. Not languishing in the same old self or you, because God is always pushing us to do more. Those are the root causes. How is he blind? What happened? Who sinned? Is it him? Did he sin? Did his parents sin? Who's to blame for this? You know, what is it? It's those three things. It's either the devil, the trial we're going through, where God's trying to help you and I. Be tempered and be stronger. Learn something for our benefit. Or it's just us disobeying God. These issues in life. Let's look at this woman lastly as we close. Look at what happened, this woman. And this is where I want to spend a little bit of time. If we're going to be healed, we need to be like this woman. We need to copy what she had done.
We need to push the crowd out of the way. We need to make room for God. We need to pursue God with all our heart. We need to seek Him. What is the Bible? Isn't that what the Bible says? That you'll be found by me if you seek me with all your heart, all your mind, all your soul. If you love me, and you need to love me. That's the first commandment, with all your heart, all your mind, all your soul, your being, every fiber in you. You need to love Him. You need to serve Him. You need to search for Him. And if you do that, you will find Him, and you will seek Him, and He will be found. You have to give it your all. You have to exhaust everything to follow Him, to touch Him, to get, again, healing, direction, guidance, wisdom. We need to be adamant, active in our faith, and say, you know what, God, I need you. God, I call on you. God, go before me. God, hear me. God, give me favor. God, move in this situation. And this woman, she was adamant. Have you ever been so adamant about something? Have you ever been so sought out, seeking after something and wanted it so bad? How many ever had something you wanted so bad? Oh, nobody. There's things we seek after. Oh, man, I need a Korean hot dog, and I know Saskatoon has it, you know, and I'll find it if it's the last thing I'll do in this life, you know. What is it? You know, you're not food. Not food. Maybe it's something else, you know. I know God is going to set it aside for me. Something you sought after. What did you do to attain it? Relationships. Dating. I mean, I know we all had been there. We all sought dating. We all had sought, you know what? Oh, I want to get with him. I want to get with her. You know, I'll buy them this. I'll do this. I'll smell this way. I'll brush my teeth. You know, you did everything you could to attain that person's love. Took a shower more than once a week. Amen. You, and this talking to men, you know. You combed your hair. You shaved, you know. And ladies, you know what? You stopped walking around in pajamas all day long. And you combed your hair. Amen. I was telling the girls, get ready. Why? Because you just need to be ready. Why? And I'm like, geez, you've been wearing that shirt for 2 days, and you're wearing those cutoffs or pants for 2 days, or they're night clothes, you know? It's like, wear something nice. And they always miss out, because we always go out once in a while. I say, yeah, you snooze, you lose. Why'd you go there? Well, you got to be ready. You got to be ready. If there's something you wanted so bad, how many know you'd exhausted every effort? I want that. That woman, I want to be healed. I want to be healed. And she did everything she could in her power. And then finally she heard Jesus was coming. And she sought after them. She said, if I could just touch the hem of his garment, if I could just touch his clothes, I will be healed. And her faith, and that's what it's going to take for you and I to get delivered, to get healed, to deal with some of these issues in our life. God is the only one who can help me. I mean, you know, God is the only one who can help you and I. God bless all these wonderful programs, but how many know ultimately God is the one, and His Word is the one that brings true deliverance in a person's life. Case in point, you hear people who were once, you know, in addiction mode. They were alcoholics. They were drug addicts. And then they say, you know what? Once I got saved, once I gave Jesus my heart, once I invited him into my heart, and it changed my life, and I've never gone back again. I've heard it over and over. Jesus set me free. I went cold turkey, and now I'm free. people who were once alcoholics. I've kicked the habit. Jesus Christ set me free. They believed that Jesus would cure him and heal him, just like this woman. And you got to have faith. As he says, your faith, daughter, has made you well. You're healed. Go, amen, and be blessed by that. And she goes, not having to deal with that issue. You're healed of your affliction. Go in peace. And it was her faith that was activated. You need to trust God. You need to go to God and say, you know what, God, I tried everything. God, I need you to move for me. I need you to touch this area in my life. Audrey and I, before I close, when we could not have a baby, we could not have a baby. And for over a year, almost 2 years, we tried and tried and failed. And then finally we said, you know what, let's go to this evangelist. Let's just have him pray for us, Audrey. And his name was Jesus Becerra. And I remember he gave Audrey a word and he said, you know what, sister, pray with me. There's some issues of selfishness in your heart. He pinpointed it. He says, God told me that there's this issue and you need to deal with it. Are you wanting to deal with it? And let me tell you, that was God, man. That was Rhema, man. That was a voice from God. And he says, you know what? You need to deal with that. You cannot be selfish and begin to start a family. Because, I mean, no, starting a family, it's not about you. It's about your children and caring for them. And he says, you know what? God doesn't want you to start off on the wrong foot here. And so we dealt with that. We prayed for that issue of barrenness. And as we prayed a month later, unbeknownst to me, Audrey is pregnant. And 2 months later, 3 months later, I find out, or when was it? Or a month later, right? Something like that. I get a Christmas card and it says, we'll see you in July, Daddy. And I'm like, what? What's this? This is a weird card, you know? And then there's a little ultrasound, I guess. And I was like, what is this? Black and white picture. And I'm like, what? Is this really for me? You know, I'm like, what kind of card is this? We'll see you in June. It was actually June. And I'm like, okay. And I realize Audrey, you know what? She was pregnant. And I wasn't dumb and say, how did this happen to you? I knew how it happened. I had some guy say, how did this happen to you? Duh. I knew exactly. And it was an answered prayer. Let me see, let me tell you, God knows your issue. God knows what you're dealing with, whatever it is. You need to go before God. Say, God, there's this nagging issue in my life. You know how long it's been there. God, I need you to deliver me. I need you to heal me. I need you to help me. Break it, God. Begin to break it. Break me, God. Whatever it needs to happen, do it, God. Your will be done, not my will. Let's bow our heads all over this place. We all have issues. How are we dealing with it? How are you dealing with it, folks? We need to go to God just like this woman. She knew exactly what she needed to do. I just need to go to Jesus. I just need to have an encounter. I just need to touch him. And I will be healed. Tonight you need to begin to say, I need God to heal me. I just need to encounter the living God. And you will. Tonight and in the coming weeks as we deal with issues in life. Let's pray tonight. If you're not right with God or you're backslidden, I want to pray with you. Let me tell you, there's all kinds of things happening in the world today. Earthquakes, tsunamis. Taiwan just had a 7.5 earthquake, landslides. All kinds of things happening in the world. Iran threatening now America and Israel. Let me tell you, this is coming down. Things are happening. If you're not right with God, you need to get right. Get your life in order. Because there's a time Jesus is going to come back. We don't know when, but he's coming back very soon. We're seeing all these things begin to happen. We don't know the time, but you know what? We see the signs. We read it in the Bible. says you need to be ready. You're not right. Maybe you're back. So I want to pray with you. Be prepared, amen, and continue to stay prepared and reorchestrate your life to where it's going to honor God. I want you to pray this prayer. Say, Lord Jesus, I come before you tonight. I admit I've sinned against you. Forgive me of all my sins. I repent of them tonight. I look to you, Lord, author and finisher of my faith. Cleanse me. Wash me clean with the blood of Jesus. I believe you died for me, Lord Jesus, and you rose from the dead 3 days later. Come into my heart. Come into my life. Change me, Jesus. Save me, oh God, in Jesus' name. Help me this day forward to walk with you. Fill me with your spirit, I pray. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Pray that every day. Ask God, oh God, cleanse me, keep me. Tonight, I want to open this altar before we go, and I want to open up to you. Find a place to pray. God is dealing with you. This altar is open about issues that you are dealing with. You're going to begin to bring it to the forefront and deal with it. Tonight, you're going to begin to deal with it. Oh, God, here I am, God. God, there's this that has been nagging in my life, this issue. I need to get it dealt with. God, I need it. God, help me, Lord God, in this area of my life. God, I'm praying, Lord Jesus, begin to work it out of me. Begin to do a work in me, Lord Jesus. Change me. God, change this situation. Change the way I feel. Change these circumstances I am dealing with. These nagging issues in my life. It has been going on too long. Father, I'm praying for healing and deliverance. Oh, God, touch us. God, touch your people right now. Oh, Father, begin to bring healing. God, begin to bring deliverance, Lord Jesus. Father, we need you. Oh, Father, nothing else will do. Lord, we seek you tonight. Lord, with all our heart, all our mind, all our soul, Lord Jesus. We seek you, Lord God. We need you, Lord God. God, begin to break some things, my Lord. Oh, Lord Jesus, we need you. We call upon you. Begin to heal, Lord God, I pray. Those with the issue, God, of whatever they're dealing with tonight, begin to work, Lord God, on our hearts and behind the scenes. Worthy, 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 oh Jesus, hallelujah, 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 Jesus, praise God, issues in life, we're gonna close here, but I want to, again, just tell you, pray for those things, begin to pray for those issues, you know, this week, especially, ask God, God, help me, how do I deal with this? How do I begin to be set free from this? Show me a way, God, deliver. And ask God to help you, amen. And seek him for those things continually. Until how long? Until it happens, amen. Until it happens. Keep praying, I tell people when I pray for healing. If they feel a little bit of healing, I say, keep praying, contend for healing. You had to keep contending. You had to keep praying. God, heal my body in the name of Jesus. And we must do that always. You got to keep fighting, amen, for those things, amen. We're going to close in prayer. God bless you. Father, we thank you for this evening we've gathered. God, I'm praying, God, begin to break some issues in our life. Help us, deliver us, God. Comfort us, go with us as we go from this place. Lord, bring us back safely again, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord God. We give you all the glory and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you today.